let us look into other type of drugs categorized as antimicrobials. So you know the drugs are the diseases in human beings or diseases in animals are caused by a variety of organisms, variety of microorganisms. Like virus, bacteria, fungi, and yeast. Okay, so the variety of microorganism starting from the lowest in size is virus, then bacteria, fungi, this yeast and molds. All this fungi, yeast and molds, all those things, they cause variety of diseases. So any substance or any substance either synthesized or for obtained from natural sources which can act on this or by acting on this are grouped together as antimicrobials. So since all these are classified as microbes, microbes are organisms which are responsible for creating a disease. So anything which acts against the microbe is antimicrobials. Okay. So in this antimicrobial, the search for antimicrobials was happening for a very long time. And in 1906 only, Dr. Paul Ehrlich succeeded in giving a thing called Selvarsen. Okay. So this is, he gave a drug called Selvarsen and he has even got a Nobel Prize for that. So this Selvarsen is actually a chemical compound called arsphenamine. It's a chemical compound called arsphenamine. And he found that this arsphenamine usage has caused a lot of toxicity to the users, especially human beings, so it has to be discarded. So then he started working on azo dyes. These azo dyes, and then he has actually come out with a thing called prontosil. This has happened in 1932. This prontosil, the prontosil is getting converted in the body to sulfanilamide. So getting converted into the body, getting converted as sulfanilamide. So instead of making a prontosil, they have directly manufactured or directly synthesized sulfanilamide. So the sulfanilamide is the first sulfur drug or sulfanamide drugs which are discovered. They're leading to the development of lot of other sulfanamides or sulfur drugs. The leading sulfur drug now is sulfapyridine. Okay, this is sulfapyridine. So, but during this time, when this was active, but in 1929, Dr. Alexander Fleming discovered penicillin. The penicillin was a breakthrough drug where when this Alexander Fleming was actually casually landed on getting this penicillin, he found that a group of microorganisms like penicillin are able to destroy the bacteria, that is the disease-causing microorganisms. So since these are themselves are microorganisms, penicillin themselves are microorganisms, which causes the destruction of other microorganisms, they are termed as antibiotics. Okay, so what are antibiotics? Antibiotics are microorganisms which have the capability to destroy other disease-causing microorganisms. So using the same thing, you are able to kill the other harmful things. So the group of substances called antibiotics have come. And Dr. Alexander Fleming has done a very extensive research for more than 10, 12, 13 years about the usage of penicillin, and it is found to be very effective on many things like this thing. This was also used for syphilis. Like syphilis, when a lot of people were dying of syphilis during the World War, this Alexander Fleming's penicillin only started actually has given them the boon, so that many people got recovered. So a lot of trials on this drug were also done. So this leading to the start of penicillin has actually really revolutionized this thing, so that there are two type of drugs. One is antibiotics, which are developed from microorganisms. All these sulfur drugs which are this thing are called antibacterials. Okay, they are antibacterial means they are also against bacteria, but here they are able to kill the bacteria. Okay, so now that leads to the actually further dividing of antimicrobials in terms of their capacity either to kill the bacteria or to resist the growth of the bacteria. So that leads to the two these things like bactericidal and bacteriostatic. So there are two types of antimicrobials which have come into the this thing. So that one is bactericidal, the drug which is able to kill the bacteria altogether, and bacteriostatics, they prevent the growth. Okay, so once the growth of the bacteria is prevented, their population is decreasing. Then after a period of time, the natural mechanism of the body through WBCs are able to take care of the disease. Whereas the bactericidals, they directly kill the bacteria. So the examples of them are like penicillin. And of course, a lot of derivatives of penicillins have come. And of course, we have even... for that matter, chloramphenicol, all those drugs. And bacteriostatic drugs are erythromycin. Okay, there are certain other drugs like erythromycin which are able to only prevent the growth of the bacteria. And so... tetracycline, erythromycin. Okay. So, they were even this... 1 minute. Okay. And you have lot of synthetic penicillins like ampicillin, amoxicillin, etc., which are also the thing. Then the latest one is ofloxacin. Okay, even chloramphenicol comes under. Bacteria. So this erythromycin, tetracycline, chloramphenicol prevent the growth of the bacteria. So they are bacteriostatic, whereas penicillin, ampicillin, amoxicillin, ofloxacin and all, they kill the bacteria altogether. So this is one type of classification of antimicrobial as bactericidal and bacteriostatic. Then there is another classification by way of their spectrum, narrow spectrum. The antibiotics are classified or subdivided into two type of category. One is narrow spectrum antibiotics and broad spectrum or narrow spectrum drugs and broad spectrum drugs. More than this thing, you can take general as antimicrobials instead of having this as antibiotic classification. Let us have another this thing of antimicrobials. One is narrow spectrum, other is broad spectrum. Narrow spectrum means their action is restricted to few of the bacteria or some of the bacteria and some of the virus like that. So examples of them are penicillin, Okay, so penicillin, even for example, some of the sulfonamides, they are also a rarospectrum antibiotics. Sorry, no respectrum antimicrobials. Whereas broad spectrum means they are able to attack both the gram positive. Here they act either on the gram positive, mostly in the gram positive bacteria. Whereas they act as both in the gram positive and gram negative bacteria. And even in some of the cases, viruses, fungi and all. So these broad spectrum examples are chloramphenicol, ampicillin, amoxicillin, etc. So antimicrobials forms the major chunk or the major important classification based on the mode of action or the therapeutic action. So we have found that the antimicrobials can be of two types, bactericidal, bacteriostatic, based on their action on the bacteria. And depending upon their wide spectrum, the range of their activity, it can be a narrow spectrum or a